The light of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
worship with hymn phone on page 377. Lift high the cross. 377. Sin. We We deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God, who is faithful and just, will forgive our sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Holy and healing God, we confess that we are in bondage to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. In the mercy of Almighty God, Jesus Christ was given to die for you. For his sake, God forgives you all your sins. To those who believe in Jesus Christ, he gives the power to become the children of God, and he bestows on them Holy Spirit. Amen. Our gathering hymn is found on page 131. Christ is risen. Alleluia. 131.
Christ is risen. In all. girl doing? I'm with you.
Just be with
me. Please be with you too.
Please be with you.
Please be with me.
Excuse me.
Please be with you.
Please be with me.
Please be with
me.
Thank you.
together. O God, you gave your only Son to suffer death on the cross for our redemption, and by his glorious resurrection, you delivered us from the power of death. Make us die every day to sin, so that we may live with him forever in the joy of the resurrection. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated and we will continue our worship with the reading of Scripture.
In every nation, anyone who fears him and does what is right is acceptable to him. You know the message he sent to the people of Israel, preaching peace by Jesus Christ, who is Lord of all. That message spread throughout Judea, beginning in Galilee after the baptism that John announced, how God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Spirit and with power, how he went about doing good and healing all who were oppressed by the devil, for God was with him. We are witnesses to all that he did, both in Judea and in Jerusalem. They put him to death by hanging him on a tree, but God raised him on the third day and allowed him to appear, not to all the people, but to us, who were chosen by God as witnesses, and who ate and drank with him after he rose from the dead. He commanded us to preach to the people and to testify that he is the one ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead. All the prophets testify about him, that everyone who believes in him receives forgiveness of sins through his name. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
As the first day of the week was done, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary taken to the tomb, and suddenly there was a great earthquake. For an angel of the Lord descended from heaven, came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothing white as snow. For fear of him, the guards shook and became like dead men. But the angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid. I know that you are looking for Jesus, who was crucified. He is not here, for he has been raised, as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples. He has been raised from the dead, and indeed he is going ahead of you to Galilee. There you will see him. This is my message for you." So they left the tomb quickly with fear and great joy and ran to tell his disciples. Suddenly Jesus met them and said, "Greetings." And they came to him, took hold of his feet, and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brothers to go to Galilee. There they will see me." Word of God, word of life, this is the gospel of our Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
But Jesus was not there. They went to get the others, and something would happen that would change the world forever. Listen to the story of Jesus' resurrection. Jesus said to him, "Because you have seen me, you have believed. Blessed are those who have not seen and yet have believed." Amen.
Their focuses in life,
changed radically because they witnessed the risen Christ. And if we truly understand the power and the promise of Jesus' resurrection, then we will be permanently changed by it too. For starters, his resurrection turns our grief into joy. Through him, our greatest enemy, which is death, has been swallowed up in victory. Our bodies may die, but our souls will rise to eternal life because Jesus gave his life as a ransom for us, and he defeated the power of death. We no longer live in fear of death and decay, and we do not grieve as those who have no hope. Our grief is tempered with joy because we know that God is faithful to his promise, that one day he will wipe away every tear from our eyes, and there will be no more death, nor pain, nor crying. And we are called to live in assurance of God's promises now, to live joyfully now, to live as children of the resurrection now, not just on Easter Sunday, but every day of our lives until the day when those promises are finally and joyfully fulfilled. Secondly, his resurrection has also turned our separation into reconciliation with God. That's the second promise we receive through his life. Remember that when Jesus was dying on the cross, only the women and the beloved disciple John were with him. All the other disciples ran away. So when an angel told the women to go quickly and tell the disciples that Jesus was going ahead of them into Galilee, I wonder what they were expecting. Were they afraid that Jesus might condemn them? That he would punish them, maybe them, for abandoning him? If so, they did not need to worry very long. As the woman ran from the tomb, Jesus suddenly appeared to them and said, "Don't be afraid. Go tell my brothers. Go to Galilee. There they will see me. Do not be afraid, and go tell my brothers." Those are not words of condemnation. Those are words of grace. Even though the other disciples had abandoned him, Jesus still called them brothers. And he assured the women that there was no reason to fear. As John 3:17 tells us, "For God did not send his Son into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through him might be saved." Jesus certainly had good reason to reject or condemn his disciples after his resurrection. But he had died specifically so that his blood would be the final sacrifice that covered over our separation from God. His death healed our separation and restored our relationship to God. And the final thing we learn from the Easter story is that Jesus' resurrection is not the end, but it's the beginning of a whole new story. This is not like the old Western movie where all the good guys ride off into the sunset together. His resurrection is the beginning of a new life for his followers, for you and I. It's the beginning of a new calling. Go make disciples of all people, baptizing them in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. It is the beginning of a new adventure in living as Jesus would live in our families and communities and schools and workplaces. And if we are followers of Jesus Christ, this is our new story too. Would like to close with a story that illustrates to me what this resurrection life looks like. It is the story of a young man who was dead spiritually but came alive thanks to the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Casey Diaz was just a teenager when he became the leader of the Rockwood Street Lobos, a street gang in Los Angeles. After years of vandalism, robbery, and violence, Casey was arrested and sentenced to 13 years in prison for second-degree murder and 52 counts of armed robbery. In prison, he became a shot caller. I had to look that one up. A shot caller marks people for life or death behind the prison walls. Casey would randomly pick any other inmate in the prison and mark him for death, and someone in his crew would see that he was dead in a short period of time. When the warden discovered that Casey was a shot caller, He sent him into solitary confinement. Inmates in solitary had almost no contact with other human beings. But one day, Casey heard a woman's voice outside his cell. She asked if she could speak to this young man in solitary confinement. The guard said to the woman, "Don't waste your time on him." She answered, "Jesus came for him too." Then she spoke to Casey from the other side of the steel door. "I'm going to pray for you, but there's something else I want to tell you. Jesus is going to use you. Every time I'm here, I'm going to come by and remind you that Jesus is going to use you." A year later, Casey was lying in his cot when he had a vision of Jesus carrying his cross up the hill to Golgotha. And just before he was crucified on it, he looked at Casey and said, "I'm doing this for you." Casey fell to his knees on the floor of his cell and began praying and confessing his sins. He began weeping. He called for a prison chaplain. The chaplain explained that Casey had just experienced salvation through Jesus, and they gave him a Bible. He began reading his Bible for hours every day, and when he was finally released into the general prison population, Casey began telling other inmates about his new life as a follower of Jesus Christ. Other inmates targeted him for beatings because he had lost his power as a shot caller. But he no longer cared. All he cared about was ministering to his fellow inmates and sharing the message of Jesus with them. After completing his prison term, Casey opened a small business, and to the amazement of everyone who knew him in his prior life, he became a pastor. Before he became a follower of Jesus, Casey gained respect by marking others for death. Now he spreads the message of new life in Jesus Christ. It's important to note that after Jesus' resurrection, his followers, his disciples, endured persecution, imprisonment, and death in order to spread the message of his life to the ends of the world. They were so certain that this obscure carpenter from Galilee was the Messiah sent from God that they staked their lives on it. So what about us? Can we remain neutral? Will we leave here the same people we were when we came in this morning? I pray that when we leave here today, our lives will be marked by joy, reconciliation, and courage that flows from the power of Jesus' resurrection. Amen. Let us confess what we believe in as Christians found in the Apostles' Creed. Oh, I'm sorry. We're going to sing a song, "Thine is the Glory," found on page 145. Thank you, Daddy. 145.
Thank you.
together in trust and hope, we confess our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again. He descended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Please join me in the prayers of the people. Lord Jesus Christ, ordained by God as judge of the living and the dead, you are Lord of all. Resurrected Lord, fill us with your grace, for we are your people. Set our minds on heavenly things. Fill us with your joy. We give thanks to you, Lord God, for you are good and your mercy endures forever. Set our minds on heavenly things. Fill us with your joy. Lord Jesus Christ, preacher, healer, first person raised from death forever, you are ordained by God, and from you we receive the forgiveness of sins. Set our minds on heavenly things. Fill us with your joy. Resurrected Lord and great physician, we boldly bring before you those in need of your loving power. Evangeline Meese, Jerry Basford, Helen Hoffman, Martha Sorensen, Andrew Hoffman, Jimmy Herring, Joel Humphreys, Arlette Cole, Stacy Roberts, Lee Cantu, George Romo, Don Nelson, Wesley Johnson, Jack Wagner, Pastor Mauricio Franco, Jennifer Baird, Andrea Gordon, Karina Ortega, Delore Arkfeld, Joyce Hussey, Virgil Swanberg, Betty Redfern, Andrea Olson, Sterling Boykin, Cody Parker, Joe Marie Thomas, foster families, all members of the armed forces, all law enforcement and first responders. We lift all those who have not been named here, either out loud or in the silence of our hearts. May God's healing presence give them peace and hope in their time of need. For those who have experienced your unconditional love, we thank you, gracious God. Set our minds on heavenly things. Fill us with your joy. Lord Jesus Christ, visit our tombs, remove our headstones that oppress us even now, and become our chief cornerstone, that we may proclaim by deed and voice with Mary Magdalene, I have seen the Lord. Set our minds on heavenly things. Fill us with your joy. All worlds know of your power, Lord God, and sing your praises. For you alone are the Holy One. Hear us even now as we join your heavenly choir. Set our minds on heavenly things. Fill us with your joy. God of peace, we pray for the people of Ukraine. We pray for all of those who fear for tomorrow, that your spirit of comfort would draw near to them. We pray for those with power over war or peace, for wisdom, discernment, and compassion to guide their decisions. Above all, we pray for all your precious children, at risk and in fear, that you would hold and protect them. Set our minds on heavenly things. Fill us with your joy. Lord of the harvest, you declare that the harvest is plentiful and invite your people to pray earnestly for laborers in your harvest field. Be with the faculty and staff of Harvest Workers, our online ministry training program, as they equip future leaders for mission. To Today we also give thanks for St. Paul in New Brunsfield and their pastors, Paul Owens and Timothy Sternberg. Bless their ministry both now and for generations to come. Set our minds on heavenly things. Fill us with your joy. Help us listen closely to your word, even as you listen to our prayers. Amen. Continue our worship with the morning offering. Forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me. Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. These are the gifts of God for the people of God. Come to the table, for all is now ready.
Thank you.
Let us pray. We give you thanks, Almighty God, that you have refreshed us through the healing power of this gift of life. And we pray that in your mercy you would strengthen us through this gift in faith toward you, in fervent love toward one another, for the sake of our Lord Jesus Christ. And now, may the Lord bless you and keep you, and may the Lord's face shine upon you and to be gracious to you. May the Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. Amen. Our sending hymn today is found on page 151. Jesus Christ is risen today. 151.
Thank you. they should, huh? Okay.
I'm not going to go back to that man.